I'm Chantal Follins, and this is The Sit Down. I'm joined by actor Niecy Nash, the newest member of the Hollywood Walk of Fame and star of the hit TV drama Claws. Good morning, superstar.
Hello, girl.
How are you?
Listen, I am still on cloud nine.
You have to be.
Listen, and I was telling everybody, like, oh, where can I find your star? And I said, you know, they told me originally, you're going to be right in front of the Pantages.
Oh, my.
Right across the street from the W. Where am I? Girl, I'm right in front of good old CVS. And I love every minute of it, huh?
We love it.
Go get your cold cream, a pack of gum, and visit my star.
Yes, you can get 2 for 1, okay? So before we get into your star, I have to let you know, I got my nails done especially for you today. I've never gotten this color before, and I said I'm doing it just for you.
Let me tell you what, I peeped this very delicious lemon sorbet of sorts.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, when I first sat down, I said, oh, look at that color.
Do you approve?
Claws up.
Claws up.
Yeah,
okay.
For sure.
Niecy Nash, sign of approval. Okay, yes. Thank you. So anywho, you are now cemented in Hollywood. You just received your star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. What was that day like for you?
The day itself was beautiful. Leading up to the day, not so much.
Oh, what happened?
It was just everything that could happen, happened. You know, mm-hmm. You know how it is. Mm-hmm. You know, I didn't tell my stylist that I hadn't been working out for 6 months. So when they brought all of the clothes, only one dress fit. So then I had to have another fitting, and I still ended up with the only dress that fit the first time.
Uh-oh.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Just different little things were falling apart, and it was just bedlam. And I kept saying, I'm going to have a good time. I'm going to have a good time at this ceremony. And I was walking out the door. I was finally dressed. Everything was together. And my fingernail broke.
No.
And I was like, what? How am I on Claws? And this is my day and my fingernail broke. Crisis averted. We put it back together. I went to the ceremony. And what the best thing I did for myself was to give someone else my phone.
Mm.
And so I wasn't present to capturing my day for other people. I was present to experiencing my day for myself.
Mm.
Yes. And then I got my phone back at the end of the day and was just happy to go through it and see what people got on my phone.
That's amazing. So you were covered. You know, you got back on balance.
I was covered.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So how does it feel to have a star before Oprah?
Listen, okay, I didn't know Oprah didn't have a star.
I didn't either.
But the one thing that I will tell you is that she reached out to me on the day.
Oh, did she?
She did. Oh, what?
What did she say?
Wait a minute. You know, some things is best left between best friends and... no, just kidding. she basically said that God confirmed his word for you on this day. You know, and then after she saw when it all came together, she texted me and said, baby, no, she said, honey, Marilyn Monroe is turning over in her grave.
Wow.
And she put bravo with a whole lot of claps, clapping emojis.
Sign of approval from Queen Oprah.
From the queen.
We love her.
What else can you say?
I mean, hey, what a way to have it cemented.
Listen.
So we've known you as a comic actor from your days on Reno 911, and now you're starring on Claws, a TNT drama where you play a nail artist, Desna Sims. You know, tell me, what is it like playing this character going from comedy to drama? What's that transition been like for you?
Well, I think I'm dramatic, but I don't think our show is a drama.
Mm-hmm.
Not to me. I feel like it's a delicious hybrid.
Okay.
I don't carry the funny in the show for sure. But the one thing that I will tell you is that it's delicious to be invited into another part of the party.
Mm-hmm.
I had been, you know, told you're funny, you do over the top comedy, and that's what we know you for.
Mm-hmm.
So it took a while to invite people to see me how I saw myself. But I just kept reintroducing myself until they got it.
Okay, let mm-hmm. them know.
Mm-hmm.
What do you love the most about playing Desna?
Oh, wow. What I love the most about playing Desna Sims is that she's on the south side of 40. She is a full woman, literally and figuratively. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Thicker than a snicker. No, no sample sizes here, guys. I love that she is a friend and a really good friend, a nurturer. I love that she's her own woman. She has sex for her own pleasure.
Yes.
I love that she's a boss. I just enjoy her. And I love that, you know, women who live in this body type get to see themselves as sexual beings. I love that she represents women who are over 40 with no kids and not married. There are many things about her that I adore. Now, let's just take a beat. Does mother enjoy those tight jumpsuits? Listen. On occasion, but it's very challenging to be in skin-tight clothes all day long, mm-hmm. especially when you live in a city that has the best, I mean, when you work from a city that has the best food ever. Okay. Down in New Orleans, and then it's like everything is fried in grease and dipped in gravy, and then they want to put you in something that's two sizes too small. Into my defense, okay, maybe it wasn't too small when I first got it. But a couple weeks in, the seams are screaming. And you're like, Lord, help me.
Now, listen, outside of whatever role you play, you have always been a fashionista, glamorous. You've always brought it. Now, tell me, have nails always been a regular part of your routine?
Nails have always been. I've been getting my nails done since I was probably about 13 or 14.
Wow.
And I've always, when I started, you know, I calmed down the older I got, but I started with the bells and the whistles and, you know, all of the long nails and bright colors and all of those things. So, yes, that has always been a thing of a thing.
All right. So in a typical week, how many times do you have to change your nails for the show?
In a typical week, you could maybe have 5 to 10 nail changes, depending.
Wow.
Depending, you know, on how we're shooting. That's why on the show, our nail tech, Morgan Dixon, makes custom press-ons for us.
Okay. So you're just keeping them.
Yeah,
changed.
We just keep changing them over.
Okay, amazing. Mm-hmm. So we have to get to a special tweet here.
Oh, we do?
On Sunday, you shared this tweet about your daughter.
What did I say?
Acting debut. Look who's playing Teen Desna. Go, Dia. They were seeing girls to play Desna, and I told Dia she should go in for it. Let me help you with the audition, I said. Her reply, I'm good. I will go over with my acting coach. Me, my baby is growing up. She booked it on her own. So precious. So tell me, what was it like seeing your baby girl playing you on television?
Well, first of all, let's just back up to the tweet. She read me for filth.
She kind
of
did.
I was like, let mommy help you with that, dear. She was like, I'm good.
Did you have any reservations about that?
No, I had no reservations about it at all. You know, the thing of it is that, you know, you want what your kids want for themselves. Mm-hmm. And if that's what you want to do, you know, go for it. Now, I'm not going to give you a career. I very much want you to know that when I'm dead and gone, you got to know how to go get mm-hmm. it. So, you know, I didn't, you know, do anything to make her get this job. I said, you guys are gonna see some girls, see her too. Please know from me, hear me say, this is not a have to. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's not called show friends, it's a business. Mm-hmm. So if she doesn't book it, she doesn't book it. But now when she did say to me, I wanna work with someone other than you on this audition, that's when I got nervous. Cause I'm like, mama got the secret sauce. I know the mojo. I can help you get this thing. And she was like, no, I got a coach, I'm good.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, and then she got it.
That's so precious. Well, speaking of family,
yeah.
Your co-star, Karrueche Tran, has been very vocal about your support of her career and how you've just been an advocate for her. How important is it for you to advocate for women and pay it forward in the industry?
Well, let me start by saying that I've never gotten a job and not gotten somebody else a job. I don't play those games. I never hoard a blessing. You know what I mean? It's enough to go around. If I'm eating, I want some other folks to eat too. That particular role, they were a little stuck on. And I said, let me bring somebody to the table for you to consider for this. And she had gone back, I think, about 3 or 4 times. She didn't even know that I was the advocate.
Wow.
Until after the fact. So I'm happy to be a champion, not just of women, but anybody who is looking to live their dream. You know, I've helped people get music placed in the show. I've, you know, referred actors and wardrobe. The wardrobe person that we have now, who was creating all the looks this season, was somebody who came from my watch. So I'm happy to pay it forward any way I can.
That's amazing. So being a blessing and paying it forward, that's amazing.
You have to. Truly. How are you just going to be selfish? Okay. That's ugly.
It is. Let them know.
Don't be selfish.
Don't be selfish. Let them know. So since you have now become a nail tech expert on the show, on set all the time, I want to see just how much of a nail tech expert you become. So we're going to play a little game.
Oh, Lord.
Okay? It's going to be called Name Those Nails. Are you ready to play? So I'm going to show you a picture mm-hmm. of a celebrity's nails.
Okay, okay.
And I want you to tell me what celebrity those hands belong to.
Okay, let's do it.
Are you ready?
Yep, where do I look?
All right, so you're gonna look right here.
Right there, okay, go for it.
All right, first up, it's either Rihanna, Beyonce, or Ciara.
Riri.
Yes, okay.
Ding.
Next
she's
up.
So beautiful.
So gorgeous, we love her. We have Jennifer Lopez, Karrueche Tran, or Demi Lovato.
I know these little rusty hands. That's nobody but that Karrueche, you know, because she worries me to death with those little paws all the time. So I know those are her hands.
Oh, my gosh. That's hilarious. Okay. Okay, up next, we have Ariana Grande, Taylor Swift, or Kim Kardashian. It's a little tough one.
Let me say it again. I feel like that could be Ariana. And you said, are Taylor Swift? No, she not rocking the ring like that, though.
No. Ariana, Taylor, or Kim Kardashian?
Yeah, that could be Kim, though, too.
You got it, Kim Kardashian. Well, it turns out that you are a nail tech expert. So, Niecy, thank you so much for joining me today.
I'm an expert.
Congratulations on your star and just slaying everything you touch.
Thank you.
We love you here.
Thank you.
Take care. All right. Thank you all. This Sunday, make sure you tune into Claws as it airs on TNT at 9 p.m. Stay tuned for more AM to DM.